as sediment accumulates in a reservoir, the capacity of that reservoir decreases to meet various demands and beneficial uses, such as for water supply and hydropower generation.
Reservoir sedimentation is a chronic issue. It will affect all reservoirs sooner or later, simply a matter of time. In some cases, that may be a few decades. In some cases, it may be hundreds or thousands of years.
The sedimentation is affecting the project benefits for the nation's reservoirs. It's by filling up these reservoirs gradually over time, reducing the storage capacity, impairing outlets, impairing boat ramps, marinas, impairing space for recreation. And we need to look at ways to better manage sediment over the future, more sustainably.
The sedimentation rate that we see in the reservoirs is driven by, one, the weather patterns, two, the geography associated with that reservoir. When we have reservoirs in areas that have high rainfall, steep mountain valleys, high amount of sediment available to come run off the watershed, all of those things contribute to high loads that can result in accelerated loss of storage volume.
Current methods to measure reservoir sedimentation are in two ways. The first is direct measurements, where you have a boat with a depth sounder and GPS mounted to it, and you map the bottom of the reservoir, and then you compare that map that you've created to an older survey. The second way to measure reservoir sedimentation is indirectly, where you're using modeling techniques, whether it's an empirical type of model or an analytical or even physically based model, to indirectly estimate the amount of sediment accumulation in a reservoir.
One of the biggest limitations is just our capacity to do it. There's 300 some reservoirs in Reclamation's inventory, many more when you look at the whole federal sector and private as well, and there just haven't been that many surveys, and they're largely due to cost.
These traditional methods require personnel on the ground to do that and to get to these remote areas. And as budgets are limited and we try and be the best stewards of the resources we can, we have to make trade-offs. For indirect methods, the limitations are simply that our estimate is based on the quality of the data that's available to either do numerical modeling or watershed runoff estimates.
So what we're looking for in terms of an improvement in the indirect estimates of reservoir sedimentation volume is certainly perhaps a model or a method that is relatively more accurate and less time consuming for us to be able to estimate the accumulation of sediment in unsurveyed reservoirs.
And so if we can come up with less expensive ways of doing the survey or estimating in lieu of a survey what that sedimentation rate might be, that would be quite helpful to water resource managers, knowing how much water is actually being stored in the reservoir.
The prize challenge allows us to query literally hundreds of millions of people to come up with good ideas.
The exciting thing for me about a prize challenge is you get lots of people involved. There's always somebody out there with a wonderful idea, and they just need to be asked and given some time to think about it. And it's an opportunity to adopt that idea, give that person credit, and maybe some cash money.
So we're partnering with Reclamation because we both have the same needs. We both have data gaps that we'd like to assess, because we both feel that it's very important to establish where we are right now, look at our resource availability, and then look into the future and say, what's going to happen to that resource? Will we be able to provide benefits in the future? And if not, what action can we take now to preserve those benefits in the future?